And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We have killed Lady Benezia last episode. Her body is gone because we reloaded. We let the bugs, the Rachni, free. Interested to see what kind of ramifications that will prove. And yeah. Don't say a word, guys, about it. Don't want to find out through your comments. Thanks, though. I'd rather find out by playing this game. And crap, we're gonna run out of Omnigel, because these are hard for me to do. Always running out of time. Oh, I did it! I did an average one. Excellent. Okay, pistol edge 2, I'm probably gonna reduce that to Omnigel. Assault rifle and medium armor for Krogan. Nice. Liberator 3. Okay, so pistol and assault rifle. Yeah, I'm not going to use Edge 2. Or Striker 2. What's with this crappy stuff you're throwing at us now, game? Scimitar 3. That's the same one we already have. Alright, and his armor. Does he have Mercenary 1? Not as good. Not as good. Did we level up too? Hold on. We did! Oh my god, look at all the points we have. I guess we leveled up a bunch of times? We're level 19? Holy crap, Arolio. Two more charm. Biotic protection. This is great, Spectre training. 4 points. Unlock tactical armor. I'm not sure what kind of tactical armor. I'm guessing we don't have tactical armor right now. Carnage. That's pretty sweet, but I have to use all my points to get there now. How about warp and throw? Unlock lift. Okay, I'm at 2 there. And 2 inspector training for now. Rex. We'll unlock advanced overkill, increases duration, longer bursts, and drains more accuracy. Combat armor. Equip heavy armor. Hell yeah, give Rex heavy armor. Now we're just gonna buy him some heavy armor. One more point. Where should we throw it? Throw it. barrier. Let's put it into Battlemaster. These class ones are pretty good. They increase a lot of things across the board, so kind of like that. Pistols. Unlock shotguns. Take that. AI hacking. Can use decryption skill on hard objects. And of course there's all these other things. Four more points. Two more. Koyan Machinist. I don't think it's that important to give her shotguns right now. I mean, Rex and I have that, so it should be good enough. I think. Let's put the other 2 points into our class here. Quarian Machinist. 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 Alright, we are leveled. We are leveled. Alright, what's around here? Looking around for anything else that may be of use. Can't believe we went against Benezia already. Well, she obviously needed to be stopped, so it's a good thing we took care of her. Elevator to the hot labs. Wait. The Rachni are there. Right, we have to kill those. They've been cut off from the hive mind. They've been left and they can't stay here. Plus, we did promise the Rachni queen or whoever we were talking to that we would take care of them. So, there's that to deal with. So we can take this elevator. What about this restricted area? Let's head for that. Is this... Yeah, this is where we talk to some bugs. Saving. This is the elevator to restricted area? Wait. Why is... Didn't we already come through here? Hold up. It's locked now. We've been through there, the ventilation room. Unless... Apparently we need to go... to the barracks. Science station. This goes... here, I think? Oh my god, I'm crawling. What happened? Did I switch? Oh. Is that what caps lock switches it? Oh yeah. I don't ever want to walk like that. I'd rather just run everywhere. I'm not sure why that's locked now, I guess. Hold on a second. Lady Benezia locked it? So if we can go around, we'll go around. I kind of want to flip this map around. It's this one, right? Yeah, science station. What? Okay, so we have to take care of these bugs now. We can't go anywhere else. Hot labs. Alright. Typical. Get ready, guys. I can see the blips already. I'm fixing my headset, sorry. Here there be baddies. Oh, the blips are gone. Who's this? Yaroslav Tartalovkovsky?
Are you here to secure the situation?
You're right.
How are you holding up?
You must listen to me. If we do not contain our mistake, they will drop bombs from the battle stations. You understand?
Yeah, anything to do, anything to contain the threat. You let them loose?
You let these things out?
I am only following the orders. Binary Helix found an egg. It was on a derelict ship, thousands of years drifting. This was Ragnar's ship. Inside they find many eggs in cryogenic suspension.
Obviously they hatched it. The egg was ancient.
A thousand-year-old egg hatched?
Yes. Very tough to be so long frozen. That it survived the centuries. This is miraculous.
Oh yeah, miraculous.
Binary Helix planned to clone Ragnar. Mass produce them. Create an army. But when they get here, they find this egg is not a common Ragnar. It is a queen.
Yeah.
After she lays eggs, they move her to Rift Station. They are thinking that without her, they can raise the babies to be obedient.
What about a male?
Hold on. Don't you need a male to get eggs?
Queens are born carrying the genetic code of their fathers. Eggs are carried away from the colony to hatch alone. Queens can lay eggs in hours and have a colony in days. This is how they spread so quickly.
Yeah, well, the Ragnar are not obedient.
Separating them from their mother didn't work.
This was exactly the wrong thing to do.
You think?
I am thinking that without a queen, Ragnar do not develop properly. Her mind is shaping theirs. These Ragnar are uncontrollable.
We could save them. We don't want to save them. Well, we're running out of time.
This is fascinating, but we don't have time to chat.
These Ragnar are beyond saving. It is a sad thing, but they must be euthanized. I am thinking that the Neutron Purge must be set off.
Neutron Purge?
I'm not familiar with the Purge system.
It creates bursts of neutron radiation, kills everything within the station. Things beyond get genetic damage of varying degree.
There's people still on this station. Give us a minute.
Once the Purge is armed, we'll have to fight our way out. Give us a minute to patch up and rearm.
Sure, sure. I wait here. I am not so much good for searching now, yes? Mother always say I would meet a bad end.
There's people still on the station. Why are we not thinking of this? Scan me. Scan me. Anything else here? No. purge controls. Yeah, what the hell? And then we'll have to fight our way out anyway? How many of these things are there? I hope we can clear everyone to safety.
Connecting. I have full access to the facility and am at your disposal.
Crew survivors.
Are there any survivors in here?
Lady Benezia, an executive secretary of Binary Helix, is on the operations deck.
Not more, she isn't.
There
not
are
anymore.
No other living crew members within the lab structure.
Within the lab structure. Okay. So does this neutron purge just affect the hot labs?
What's the status of the facility?
Containment breach in laboratory pod Gamma. The neutron purge system is functional, but has not been armed.
I need information on the neutron purge.
The neutron purge is a fail-safe system installed within the isolation tube area. In the event of irretrievable containment loss, it is used to resolve the situation.
Resolve sounds final.
What exactly does this thing do?
The purge is a neutron burst weapon. Two volumes of fissionable materials are brought together to form a critical mass. Most of the energy is released in the form of high-speed neutrons. This radiation is instantly lethal to any known form of life within 500 meters.
Nah, just a pleasant afternoon in the sun for a Krogan.
Yeah, good talk.
The purge is lethal to all known forms of...
Shut up. Last thing I need is some virtual wench questioning my fitness.
How many Rachni are in here?
I'm sorry. The sensor network is too damaged to provide an accurate count.
Huh. Well, estimate. Are we talking dozens? Hundreds? Thousands?
Give me your best guess.
Guessing is beyond my design parameters, Commander.
Oh, brother. I'm gonna save the game.
We're moving on.
Logging you out, Commander.
Artemis Tau. Still have to go Pharos. Well, we've just saved, right? So...
Online. How can I help you?
Initiate the purge.
Activate the neutron purge.
I'm sorry, but I can't do that without proper code authorization.
Where can I get it?
Who would have the code?
Director of Operations, Yaroslav Tartakovsky, or any executive officer of Binary Helix.
He's right in the other room.
Activate the neutron purge.
I'm sorry, but I can't do that without proper code authorization.
Six Emperor Tyrann from...
That is not the correct code. Please report to security for arrest and interrogation.
Who would have those codes?
Arrest and interrogation!
Director of Operations, Yaroslav Tartakovsky, or any executive officer of Binary Helix.
Come on, Tally, weren't you listening? Yeah, I'll report for arrest right away.
We're moving on.
Logging you out, Commander.
Klaatu Barada Nucleon. Alright, Tartakovsky. Glad she said it so I don't have to figure it out myself.
I am feeling not so well.
How do I trigger the purge?
How do we set off the purge?
Arming controls are nearby. All you do is insert the key. Then I will give Mira destruct.
Guess not. We don't have the damn code. Ooh, nah.
And I'm excited.
Was that the only one? What did it throw him? Does he have, like... Okay, I guess he had it on him. You have the codes needed to activate the Neutron Purge controls. All that stuff is to order Mira to begin the countdown. Alright. We're about to make a pretty cool exit from this place. Saving again.
Online. How can I help you?
Activate the Neutron Purge.
I'm sorry, but I can't do that without proper code authorization.
I have the code.
Code input 875020079. Code Omega local execution.
Verified. Code Omega execution.
Your brother!
In 120 seconds.
Here we go. Here we go. Oh no! We can't kill these things in 120 seconds. I'm overheating. Ah! Get out of here! 120 seconds. Behind us, there's a lot. Do we have a timer on our... I'm fatigued. What did we make it? I guess we made it. Still can't go here. Well, I guess we're just going back to the tram then, which is this way? Wait. Or no, it's around here, isn't it? Ugh. So apparently it's just for the hot labs, it didn't affect this facility. Which is good. Cause we're in it. Wow, it's been a while since we've been in this place. So back to our vehicle, we're just going all the way back to Novaria Station.
What's our next move, Commander? Head for the Mu Relay?
Oh, we're back on the ship, okay. Head for the Mu Relay. There's no point. We don't know where to go from there.
The Mu Relay could link to dozens of systems. Unless we know exactly where Saren's going, we'd just be wasting our time.
The Commander's right. We can't rush off blind. We need more to go on.
What about Liara Tassoni? The Matriarch's daughter. Isn't she some kind of expert on the Protheans?
Yeah, right. Her mother was working for Saren. I bet she is, too.
But Nezia helped us in the end. Maybe Liara will, too. At the very least, we should head for the Artemis Tau Cluster to find her.
Who put you in charge? Did the commander resign when I wasn't looking?
Enough.
We're all on the same team here, Williams. She's just trying to help.
Sorry, Commander.
Don't let it happen again.
We're done here. Crew dismissed.
We don't actually
Novalia
say
it. Novalia report is away, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Yes.
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
This report accurate, Commander? You found Rachni on Novalia?
Hell yeah.
You released the Queen. Do you have any idea what you've done? How many generations until they overrun the galaxy?
Should I guess?
Three? No, four.
This is no joke, Commander. The Rachni were one of the greatest threats the galaxy ever faced.
Disconnect. Not these Rachni.
This queen is different. She understands why her kind had to be wiped out last time around.
I hope you're right, Shepard.
Me too.
My children's children will pay the price if you're not.
We'll be waiting for your next report, Commander.
Renegade and Paragon plus two. That's interesting, because we could have completely disconnected. We got new thing on ships and vehicles. I just felt
faster
like
than light drives use element.
Sovereign.
Sovereign is the flagship of the rogue specter Saren, an enormous dreadnought larger than any other ship in any known fleet. It is crewed with both Geth and Krogan. At 2 kilometers long, its spinal-mounted main gun is likely capable of penetrating another dreadnought's kinetic barriers with a single shot. How Saren acquired this incredible warship is unknown. The prevailing opinion is that Sovereign is a Geth construct, while others believe it is a Prothean relic. Its design, however, hints at a more alien and mysterious origin. The attack on Eden Prime demonstrated Sovereign's ability to generate mass effect fields powerful enough to land on a planetary surface. This implies it has a massive element zero core and the ability to generate staggering amounts of power.
Meaning I wouldn't want to go up against that ship anytime soon. Now what's our current position? Still over orbiting the star system? Novalia, yeah. Now this is what I wondered that I couldn't, I couldn't get to before it was kind of spoiled for me. Svarog? Okay, so we can't land here. It looks like a molten planet. Svarog is a small but typical hydrogen and helium gas giant whose orbit lies quite close to the star. It is unusual for a star with a close orbiting gas giant to have a habitable world. Svarog is Pax's only gas giant, but its temperature, powerful winds, and high orbital velocity make it a poor candidate for helium-3 mining. While Novalia enjoys plentiful deuterium for its fusion plants, it imports all of its helium-3 from out-system. There's that you can look at. Morana. Morana is an icy planetoid smaller than Earth's moon. Many planetary geologists suspect it was once an wart cloud ice dwarf which migrated inwards after an encounter with some other body. While the crust is frozen water ice, deeper layers are mostly silicates with pockets of magnesium and aluminum. Morana is tidally locked to Pax, the same side always faces the sun. One day is equal to over 17 years. Pretty long freaking day. And finally here, Veles. Veles has a thin atmosphere of xenon and krypton. Most other materials have frozen and fallen as snow. Its surface is composed of potassium with deposits of magnesium. While investigating the primitive anaerobic life of Veles, Binary Helix survey teams discovered a cunningly hidden anchorage of the ancient Krogan warlord Moro. Many records and artifacts of the Krogan rebellions were recovered and sold at auction. The empty base is now abandoned. I can survey this. Matriarch's writings recovered. Scans of the planet Veles revealed a small abandoned vessel. Your salvage team brought the ship on board and dismantled it, whereupon they discovered one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. Just like that, huh? Can you look at the sun? No. The star, rather. Okay, so how do I exit? Okay, journal. Asari writings. Keep searching until you find all the missing writings. Huh. Go to the Strenuous system. Search for Garrus' brother. Secondary. There's a lot of people that need our help here. Delvonner's. We're gonna need to talk to him. His name is very similar to Delvarner, a character on Babylon 5, who I think only showed up in one episode. Well, I'm not sure. He might have been a recurring character for a short amount of time. So he's our member. What's his name? Oh, Ambassador. I can't believe I can't remember his name. The one with the assistant named Veer. Lando. Lando Malari. Delvana, he would say. Before I go anywhere else, yeah, let me talk to these people, see what they have to say about anything. Not him, though, because he doesn't speak.
Yes, Commander?
Speak freely, Presley. I want to know if you have a problem with non-humans.
I trust you, Commander. If you think they belong here, then so do I.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
Point defense systems? Ooh, Codex. Guardian weapon. A ship's general area defense integration anti-spacecraft network Guardian consists of anti-missile, anti-fighter laser turrets on the exterior hull. Because these are under computer control, the gunnery control officer needs to do little beyond turn on the system and designate targets as hostile. Since lasers move at light speed, they cannot be dodged by anything moving at non-relativistic speeds. Unless the beam is aimed poorly, it will always hit its target. In the early stages of a battle, the Guardian fire is 100% accurate. It is not 100% lethal, but it doesn't have to be. Damaged fighters must break off for repairs. Lasers are limited by diffraction. The beam spreads out, decreasing the energy density, watts per M2, the weapon can place on a target. Any high-powered laser is a short-range weapon. Guardian networks have another limitation, heat. Weapons-grade lasers require cool-down time during which heat is transferred to sinks or radiators. As lasers fire, heat builds within them, reducing damage, range, and accuracy. It's like our weapons. Our weapons shut down completely, though. Fighters attack in swarms. The first few will be hit by Guardian, but as battle continues, the effects of laser overheat allow the attackers to press ever closer to the ship. Constant use will burn out a laser. Guardian lasers typically operate in infrared frequencies. Shorter frequencies would offer superior stopping power and range, but degradation of focal arrays and mirrors would make them expensive to maintain, and most prefer mechanical reliability over bleeding-edge performance where lives are concerned. Solarians, however, use near-ultraviolet frequency lasers with 6 times the range, believing that having additional times to shoot down incoming missiles is more important. Lasers are not blocked by the kinetic barriers of capital ships. However, the range of lasers limits their use to rare knife fight range ship-to-ship combat. Interesting. Heat load monitor. Huh. So still learning more about our ship here. Space combat. Combat endurance. Heat limits the length and intensity of ship-to-ship combat. Starships generate enormous heat when they fire high-energy weapons, perform maneuvering burns, and run onboard combat electronics. In combat, warships produce heat more quickly than they can disperse it. As heat builds within a vessel, the crewed spaces become increasingly uncomfortable. Before the heat reaches lethal levels, a ship must win or retreat by entering faster than light. After an FTL run, the ship halts, shuts down non-essential systems, and activates the heat radiation gear. Combat endurance varies by ship design and the battle's location. Battles in deep cold of interstellar space can go on for some time. Engagements close to a star are brief. Since habitable worlds are usually close to a star, battles over them are frantic. And just by looking at this one, we got another one. Heat management. So we'll learn all about buildup of heat here. Dispersal of heat generated by onboard systems is a critical issue for a ship. If it cannot deal with heat, the crew may be cooked within the hull. Radiation is the only way to shed heat in a vacuum. Civilian vessels utilize large, fragile radiator panels that are impossible to armor. Warships use diffuse radiator arrays, DRA, ceramic strips along the exterior of the armored hull. These make the ship appear striped to thermographic sensors. Since the arrangement of the strips depends on the internal configuration of the ship, the patterns for each vessel are unique and striking. On older ships, the DRA strips could become red or white hot. This font is a little hard to read sometimes. Dubbed tiger stripes or war paint by humans, the glowing DRA had a psychological impact on pirates and irregular forces. Ship radiations are not as efficient as panels, but if damaged by enemy fire, the ship only loses a small portion of its total radiation capacity. In most cases, a vessel's DRA alone allows it to cruise with no difficulties. Operations deep within a solar system can cause problems. A ship engaged in combat can produce titanic amounts of heat from maneuvering burns and weapons fire. When fighting in a high heat environment, warships employ high efficiency droplet heat sinks. In a droplet system, tanks of liquid sodium or lithium absorb heat within the ship. The liquid is vented from spray nozzles near the bow as a thin sheet of millions of micrometer scale droplets. The droplets are caught at the stern and recycled into the system. A droplet system can sink 10 to 100 times as much heat as DRA ships. Actually really clever. Let the liquid absorb all the heat and then get the frag rid of it. Droplet sheets resembled a surface ship's wake through the water. The wake peels out in sharp turns, spreading a fan of droplets as the ship changes vectors and leaves the coolant behind. Joker up there. Before we talk to him, I'm going to call it an episode, and we'll talk to people here and then proceed to our next destination. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and enduring. Grow strong.